Thailand's former leader Thaksin Shinawat returns after 15 years in exile. His private jet left Singapore and landed in Bangkok Tuesday morning, where he was welcomed by his supporters. Thaksin fled abroad in 2008 to avoid a jail sentence for abuse of power 2 years after the military toppled him, alleging corruption and disloyalty to the monarchy. Police earlier said he will be arrested upon his return to Bangkok and taken directly to the Supreme Court for a hearing. Thaksin is arguably Thailand's most famous politician. He founded the populist movement Phu Thai, which is set to nominate a candidate to be the country's next leader this afternoon. Hillary gave a brief respite to the summer heat wave that has increased the risks of wildfires in California. This report tells us about the low-tech and high-tech ways state officials have been dealing with the problem.
These goats are an emission here in California. As they happily munch on grass and weeds, they are making California's hills and valleys less prone to wildfires. Michael Choi is the owner of Fire Grazers, Inc.
There are a few vegetations, generally. The most important, I guess the most invasive one is mustard. The wild mustard that grows almost everywhere in the Los Angeles area. There are also others though, like star thistle and just the general grass and bush, sagebrush that grow around here that, you know, during the fire season, it's basically waiting to ignite, and the goats love it.
Today, about 300 goats make up the wildfire prevention team, along with two dogs that protect the goats from coyotes, Choi says.
They are tremendously beneficial to the soil. Another benefit would be cost effectiveness, especially with the rising gas prices. The cost of using a mowing crew is going up, especially on steep hills in canyons. Goats are natural mountaineers, so they'll climb up and down these crazy California canyons that we get in Malibu or Palos Verdes or Calabasas, and they have no problem. And they could deal with the heat as well.
The goat crew needs a couple of days to clear a hill. Then they move to a new spot. They work like this from March to October, says Choi.
We set up the fence. You know, we need to take care of them, make sure they have water and minerals and all the things.
In wildfire-prone California, clearing dry grass is mandatory. Artificial intelligence, or AI, is also being used to locate wildfires. In a joint effort, firefighters and scientists from University of California, San Diego, have set up a prevention program that relies on thousands of cameras installed around the state. The moment a wildfire is detected, a message goes to the state's emergency services.
They're pan, tilt, zoom cameras near infrared. And so we trained the AI and we built up thousands of files educating the AI. We trained the AI to recognize smoke and be able to differentiate it from dirt devils or clouds or dust.
It took scientists and firefighters years and some $100 million to train AI to detect wildfires this way. And officials say the program has been quite successful. Each year, wildfires consume wide swaths of California. In 2018, a wildfire destroyed the northern town of Paradise, killing 85 people. Scientists warn that climate change will likely cause even more frequent and aggressive wildfires. Frangelina Bogdasaran in Los Angeles, NRI's VOA News.
Well, Tropical Storm Hillary moves north after unleashing record-breaking downpours overnight across the U.S. Southwest. Well, the danger isn't over, with millions still under the threat of floods. Our North America Bureau Chief DJ Manotok now joins us with the latest on the storm. TJ, what more can you tell us?
Good evening, Camino. Well, Tropical Storm Hillary made its way through California, and thankfully, officials feared it could, based on the hurricane's original strength and potential. Hillary did leave many streets with minor floods. Some areas had downed power lines, and it did trigger mudslides in areas that were highly susceptible in the Southern California area. No deaths were recorded in the U.S., but Mexico officials did say one man was killed as he was crossing a stream and got swept away. The amount of rain Southern California got was 4 to 5 inches in coastal areas like Los Angeles and the beach areas, there was more in the mountainous ranges that saw 10 inches. Record rainfall for sure for the region that saw nearly a year's amount of rain from previous averages. Now, Monday morning saw clearer skies as Hillary traversed north to Utah and Nevada, but with much weaker rains and winds. The pockets in Los Angeles County and nearby areas that saw some flooding were Palm Springs, Cathedral City, and some flash floods in the San Gabriel Mountains that is east of Los Angeles. Local officials have advised of cleanup operations in areas that were most affected and advised residents to check their local authorities and local news to make sure the affected roads were already clear before heading out on the road. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, TJ Manotok, there joining us live. U.S. President Joe Biden visits Maui nearly 2 weeks after wildfires swept through the Hawaiian island. Biden visited the devastated city of Lahaina after a helicopter tour to survey the damage firsthand. He's also set to meet with wildfire survivors. Biden vows to stand with the people of Maui for as long as it takes.
Today is burned, but it's still standing. The trees survived for a reason. I believe it's a very powerful symbol of what we can and will do to get through this crisis. And for this, for as long as it takes, we're going to be with you. The whole country will be with you. You know, we will be respectful of the sacred grounds and the traditions that rebuild the way the people of Maui want it built, not the way others want it built. We're going to rebuild the way the people of Maui want it built. But, you know, it's going to be hard. But I also want all of you to know the country grieves with you, stands with you, and will do everything possible to help you recover, rebuild, and respect culture and traditions when the rebuilding takes place.
Biden has been criticized for his initial response to the Maui fires, which killed more than 110 people. He went several days without speaking about the tragedy while on vacation at his Delaware beach house. Meanwhile, the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department confirms the second Filipino casualty in the wildfires. 76-year-old Rodolfo Rokutan has been identified to be among those who perished in the tragedy. The Philippine consulate has reached out to his family. The DFA adds officials are verifying the identity of two more possible Filipino casualties. Former U.S. President Donald Trump turning himself in on Thursday in Georgia to face racketeering and other charges stemming from his bid to overturn his 2020 election loss. He had been given until Friday to surrender or face arrest. Trump's bond has been set at $200,000. The agreement signed by his lawyers also sets out release terms, including restrictions on intimidating witnesses and obstructing justice. Prosecutors have proposed that the trial start in March next year, while Trump's lawyers have asked for a 2026 trial. Japan will start releasing more than a million metric tons of treated radioactive water on August 24, Thursday. Prime Minister Fumio Kishida said he has asked the Tokyo Power Company to prepare for the water discharge. The plan is crucial in decommissioning the wrecked Fukushima nuclear power plant. It was approved 2 years ago by the Japanese government. The UN nuclear watchdog also saying the water release meets international standards, but some of Japan's neighbors, including China and South Korea, have opposed the plan over its potential impacts on marine life and food security.